Dear students, assalamu alaikum. I am your teacher Aisha Anwar. We are studying chapter number 2, which is about operating system. Up till now we have covered its objective, its function, its classification and different types of operating system. Today we are going to learn about the basic icons of Windows operating system. We all know that Microsoft Windows is the most popular operating system and it has graphical user interface. We all know that graphical user interface is easy to learn and easy to use. Why is it easy to use? It is easy to learn and use because it presents all the information in the form of icons, pictures, menus and pointers. So today we are going to learn about the basic icons of Windows operating system. First of all, we will discuss what is an icon. An icon is a small graphical symbol that represents a file, folder, application, or a device. There are some special system icons such as recycle bin and my computer that are kept on desktop. Icon has a label at the bottom describing its name. You can see that there are small pictures with their label under them is known as the icon. Each icon has its specific picture or specific graphics and its own name. For example, here you can see the icon of my computer, then my documents. This is the icon that represents the recycle bin of the operating system. These are the system icons that are present in every operating system. Whenever you install Windows operating system, these icons are already present with the operating system. Now here you can see some other icons. These are the icons of some applications programs that are installed in the computer. First of all, recycle bin. Recycle bin is basically a temporary place for items that users delete from the hard disk. If I delete some file, folder or a picture from computer, it directly goes to the recycle bin. The user can restore to its original location. User can also delete a file or folder permanently from the recycle bin. Whenever I am deleting a file, that file is going to the recycle bin. If I want that file back into my computer, I can restore that file back on its original location. There is an option restore present in the recycle bin. You can simply click on the file and you can see the option restore. If you will select the option restore, the file will move back to the computer in its original location, whether it is stored in C drive, D drive, on desktop or in my documents, wherever. If I am deleting a file and I don't need that file anymore, I can empty my recycle bin and can delete that file permanently. So it means a file can move towards the recycle bin, and if we don't need that file, we have to delete it again from recycle bin. But if we need that file again, we can restore that file to the system. So the icon of recycle bin is just like the dustbin. The next is my computer. My computer icon allows the user to access the contents of computer drives and manages files and folders. When user double clicks on computer icon, it will open a window that displays the drives present in the computer. It is used to navigate and manage the computer resources. Basically, every computer has hard disk. When we get ready that computer for the use, we make partitions of that hard disk. Those partitions of hard disk are known as the drives. And these drives are referred as C drive, D drive, E drive, and so on. The number of drives depending upon the partition that user has made. For example, if I want to divide my hard disk into three partitions, it will name my drives as C drive, D drive, and E drive. So, when I click on the icon, my computer, it will open a window, and that window will show these drives present in the computer. After opening my computer, I can go into the drive wherever I want to go, like C drive, D drive, and E drive. The purpose of my computer is used to navigate, manage the computer resources. All the data, files, pictures, folders are present in these drives. Either we store data in C drive, D drive, E drive. If we want to manage that data, if we want to work on that some file, we have to go to that file by using my computers, then go to the respective drive in which the data is stored, and then by opening the file. The next icon that we are going to discuss is the folder icon. Folder icon resembles a physical file or folder. It is just like the file or a folder that exists. Basically, it is used to store files. A folder can have another folder in it, which is known as subfolder. The purpose of folders is to keep files in an organized manner on a storage device such as hard disks so that they can be accessed easily. There are so many files that exist in the computer or that we save in the computer. So it is always recommended to save the similar files or folders into a collective folder or into a main folder. For example, if I have some files that are related to timetable, let's say there are 10 files of timetable, so I should create a folder named as timetable, and I have to keep all those 10 files into the one folder named as timetable. What will be its advantage? It will be easy for us to find the file when they are needed. So in this way, we can betterly organize our data which is present in the computer. If you want to save a pictures from your farewell party, then what will you do? Definitely you will make a folder named as farewell and store all those pictures of farewell party into that folder. Similarly, if you have some folders of any trip, you will name the folder as trip and save those pictures into the trip folder. In this way, it will be very easy for us to open the respective folder and find out the respective picture or data or file. So, by using folders, we logically arrange or we logically manage our data. And a folder can contain another folder inside it. And that folder is known as the subfolder. Next is file icon. File icon in a GUI, files are also represented by the icons. What is a file? A file may contain text, images, music, or videos. User recognize a file by its icon. Program icon. Executable program files are also represented by icons. Different logical symbols or different graphical symbols that are related to the programs are represented the specific program. For example, the icon of Acrobat Reader is shown in the figure. We simply see the icon and we can tell what type of a software it is. For example, there is another icon of a program that is Yahoo Messenger and Internet Explorer. There are some icons known as shortcut icons. They are created to access a program, file, or folder quickly. They have an arrow at the bottom left corner and the name below it. As you can see that there is a small arrow in the left corner of these programs, it means all of these icons are also the shortcut icons. What is the purpose of shortcut icon? Basically, you don't need to go to the original location where that program or file is residing. Instead of doing this, we create the most frequently used programs and files on the desktop with the shortcuts. When we click on that shortcut icon, I will directly go to that program or file that is required. A shortcut icon is identified with the help of this short arrowhead in the left bottom corner of any icon, and it has name written on it. Okay, dear students, that's all for today. Please revise the topic from your book. If you have any query, please feel free to ask. Thank you.